Welcome to prefabricated structures. In today's video, we will be seeing related to efficiency of material required for the design of the prefabricated structures. In the multi-story, the panels are either installed as a spandrel panels between the columns, or they may be taken from the large panels which contains the windows. The spandrel panels may be also supported by floor slabs or bracing panels, may be disposed horizontally or vertically in the later casting, and should be interconnected as not to go any relative movement. So there are the panels such as the material which is required. The spandrel materials are used between the two frame of the columns which will be provided. Nowadays we see that between the columns, a brick wall is constructed. That brick wall is called as spandrel panels in the prefabricated structures. The external surface of these panels is usually finished like a last stone finish. Means last stone finish means it has to be completed like the part of totally edged, means the complete part with painting and all things. That type of the finishings are provided, which will give an attractive appearance. Wall panels are adequate for resisting wind load, which acts first to their own plane for bearing forces. Means these wall panels are going to resist the wind loads which are acting on them. Before act any other load, the wind load is going to struck on the particular panels, and they will be coming into account for the first wind load itself only. And they are going to have the bearing of the panel with the reinforcing and in the longitudinal axis of the building. This ensures the rigidity of the panel in the longitudinal direction. Without using any other bracing structures or anything, the whole spandrel wall gets particularly the security of the having and carrying the load of wind load. These wall panels can be made of a lightweight concrete, reinforced concrete, or partially of reinforced and partially with a lightweight concrete. When the reinforced concrete is used, a heating insulating layer is also being used in this part. So the material comes with lightweight concrete to lift and reinforced concrete with less thickness, or both the combination with reinforced concrete as well as with the partially lightweight aggregate concrete. So this type of things are used in the materials. Now the particular insulating layer, why we want to provide in this RCC members, means in reinforced concrete, if we want a thickness, the insulating member is having a light amount of weight and the RCC thickness will be very much less. For that reason, a heating insulating layer is provided between the concrete structure of the walls, which is the spandrel wall. Wall panels can be divided into two groups. First to belong the panels which transfer their own weight or other vertical forms by some means to the column or frames. These are called as a horizontal wall panels. Means the wall panel is there as particular wall panel will be this. So they will be giving their own weight in or the vertical forms, other vertical forms of the weight by the same means to the column or frame. The columns or whatever the frames are provided, so those column frames will be carrying the particular loads. These called as a horizontal wall panels. Then second group of involves the panels resisting and borne directly by the footing or of the footing beams. These panels does not transfer any vertical forces to the column or frames and are called as vertical wall panels. So now the vertical panels will be resting over, so such that the vertical wall panels are resting on the horizontal beam and these are going to come in the downward direction. So this will be acting directly on the footing itself. In both the groups, solid window and must be distinguished. Though both the widths solid windowed are provided such that the window is allowed or not allowed. Then horizontal wall panel is having a width of about 0.6 to 2 meters and are self-bearing between two adjacent frames. Self-bearing between two adjacent frames means there is a frame between these. This is one frame, this is one column. They are self-adjusting in this particular frame. So this can add the transfer their load directly to the columns. So this type they panels are placed in the between the columns. A horizontal lying wall panel being a compound of a lightweight and reinforced concrete is to be seen. So we can see this particular wall and having the particular sections which are provided. The length is of a panel is 5.98 meter. So if we assume, and the width which we can, it can say the height which is width of the particular thing is 1.18 meter and the thickness is 0.2 meters. The outer surface is formed by 2.5 centimeter thick of reinforced concrete slab over with a cast stone like a layer made of a crushed stone. The other parts of the panel are made of a lightweight concrete using formed blast furnace slag and aggregate. The quality of this concrete is light concrete too is also the reinforced concrete. The embedded pieces of the angles steels for foiling and for hoisting hooks however are made. Means this particular panel is going to weigh of about 33,000 kg. Please don't take this as a panel. This is just as a demo. I am telling you this will be as a panel. So similarly the wall panel we can easily consider. So the total weight is of about 33,000 kg in example of this structure I am telling. So and height up to three of upper hinges is 41.55 meters. The gauge of the rail tracks is for 12 to 14 meters for the same machine, but with columns assembled of four sections, the data are total weight of 20,000 kg with height of 20 centimeter and track gauge of 9 meters. The maximum hoisting capacity is in both cases 35 tons using two cranes and of two cranes to the tons. Particularly 35 tons cannot be used by one single ton, one single crane. So because some of the cranes may get tilted while lifting the 35 tons at a time, so two cranes are used. If the height tower mounted cranes are there, then it can be easily lifted, but because of the wind loads and other loads, there will be maximum load acting and it may carry or it may not carry the total load which is possible by the 35 tons. The possible deviation of a hoisting by a mortar built into the structure of its permissible to move it in the unloaded state, to move it in the unloaded state itself only. Then roofing slabs or corrugated asbestos cement sheets laid on a purlins. So we have seen the particular steel structures, such as if we are preparing one of the shed is of a corrugated asbestos cement sheet or a steel sheet nowadays. So these are the most popular forms of roofing covers in the Europe. Now it is also going for our Asian continent. This is not the most surprising or simplicity of a manufacture of purlins and availability from the stock of a factory. Made by lightweight of a concrete roofing slab to the panels such as. So why these are used means very lightweight and can be carrying maximum load, for that reason they are going to use. Here nowadays we are also going to use the same type, but not for the whole structure of the building. So some part of the structure of the building we are using these structures. We have seen the industrial structures which are totally built up by the corrugated sheets and they are laid on the purlins and the columns are of the steel junctions. The structural system of a purlins may be freely supported, cantilever girder or continuous girder. So we have seen freely supported means they are directly independent, and cantilever girder means they are connected to one of the building and continuously beams or purlins are running one support another support like that. The connection of the purlins over the support are designed only to absorb the bending moment and that too the limited bending moment is to be avoided, allowed. Otherwise it will have a collapse or a bending in the particular sections, because purlins are not of that much able to carry the loads, and number of purlins will also increase. So normal purlin spans between 5 to 10 meters. The purlins are spaced at intervals of 2 to 3 meters. So the normal purlin length is, we can say, 5 meter or 10 meter. We can able to see it as a 10 meters or 13 meters. The purlins are spaced at intervals of 2 to 3 meters. So 2 to 3 meters, if we provide a spacing of a purlins adjacent to them like this. So one here, another here, another here. In this way, if we provide, that time we can say the corrugated sheets can be easily resting over them and we can take a load more. Purlins are usually solid web members. So solid web members means steel members. For a long spans, they may be lattice girders. Lattice girders or trussed beams. So we have seen there are a long span beams or long span openings are there. Then they are connected with some of the huge amount of girders or beams. Those are also known as purlins. Freely supported purlins are designed as a let flanged or fish belly members. Purlins designed as a cantilever grills or articular girders are usually parallel flanged members or parallel flanged members. The cross section feature depend on the spans of a purlins on the slope of the roof. So it depends upon the slope of the roof. Purlins for a flat roofs are usually rectangular T section or T section members. For a slippy sloped roofs, it is loaded also in a biaxial bending. Biaxial bending means two types of bending. One is in this direction, one is in this direction. So longer span direction and shorter span direction, both way direction bending will be acting. That is called the biaxial bending. L sections or channel sections are used. Purlin sections and the appropriate spans associated with them for a purlin spacing of 3 meters are indicated for flat roofs. The dimensions relate to freely supported purlins. Purlin sections with associated spans for a purlin spacing of about 1.25 meter in the case of steeply sloped roofs with a corrugated things which can be used as the purlins. Thank you and see you in the next video.